Hi, good day. In this tutorial, I'll teach you how to use the custom page feature. The custom page feature is filled with different type of features that is present on our platform. For example, through the custom page feature, you can link your email button, you can use different kind of button, you can use source code, you can use videos, you can use images, you can use a lot of things using the custom page features. Let's say, for example, you want to create documentations, you want to create books, you want to make a video a tutorial explaining how to use stuff to people. There's just a lot of things you can do with custom page, and then I'll show you today. So let's get started. You can use this box. Let's say, for example, you've just created an app, you selected your template and everything, and all you need to do is add a feature. Now I'm going to add the custom page features for you, so you see how it works. You can search the custom page feature here if you want, or then just add it by checking through the list of features that we have here. So this is the custom page feature. I'm going to click on it. I'm going to call this my page. I'm going to change the icon from the default white one to something colorful. You can see, so I'm going to add a text as the first example. I can't just so I'm going to add a text here. Let me just lorem ipsum. I'm going to just copy here. I'm going to paste the lorem ipsum here. It's just the sample of what is the color of text, so nothing serious. So you can edit your text as you wish. You can add colors, you can add whatever you basically want. You can do it with this text field. You can add links and all. Let's say you want to link this available to something, you just click here and then you paste your URL here. So I just type the google.com and then click OK. So I can change this color if I want. So that's basically it about text. There's a lot you can do with this text field. So I'm going to add another field, for example, images. I'm going to upload images. I'm going to put this. This as well. You can upload many images. Depends on the number of images you wish to actually upload. You can add video here as well. You can upload your own video by putting the MP4 here, by putting the description and the MP4 link here. You can upload your own podcast. You can upload your YouTube videos, depends on whatever you want. You can upload your address. You can add a button. Let's see, I can add this link. I can say click on new tab or open an app. I can enter, click here for more information, and I'm going to enter the link here as it has stated. Then you can do some settings. Yes, use hardware as back button, and then that's all. I'm going to click on save. So the custom page has been saved. You can also add attachments, like for example uploading a PDF document or the CSV document or anything at all. You can just add an attachment under this area. So let's see what. Okay, I added the CSV, so these are the formats that are allowed, the PDF, the GIF and all. So I don't have an attachment to hide. You can add a slider in front of my images. You just add the pictures. You can add a cover image. Let me add a cover image, for example. Let me add this QR code as my cover, and let me click on save. I'm going to just delete the slider off. Okay, so let me test what I've been doing. Let me click on see changes. So you can see my page. You can see, so basically this is how that works. You can see down here, you can see the text that I entered. This is it. This is the image, the cover, the image I had it. You can see, and this is the cover. The cover is a lot bigger. You can see it's a lot bigger than just the normal one. Then the button that I had is the button. Just click here for more information. So you can just configure this. There's a lot you can achieve with this custom page. Actually, you can add address, you can add a button like a link to another site or to another page. You can add an attachment like upload a PDF, a PNG, a lot of files that you want to upload. You can add it as an attachment. So basically, this is also one of the core features of SwiftSpeed App Creator. So this feature is available on free plan. Actually, is available to all users. So congratulations. Thank you for watching this tutorial. Please kindly subscribe to our channel and like this video. It will go a long way and we both appreciate your gesture. Do have a wonderful day ahead. Bye.